Ana, next concept is, does every statement have a meaning? Prati oka statement ki meaning untunda leda? Let us see here. Evidently the answer is no. Why? Because even if you choose perfectly sensible words and put them together, then only it has the chance of giving a perfect meaning for a given sentence. You may still get complete nonsense. Yes or not? Without the combination of the words, definitely it doesn't have the chance of giving a statement. For instance, the statement, this water is triangle. This water is triangle. Can complete the sentence? No. It does not give a complete sense. Similarly, a statement has a meaning only when there is a relation between words. When there is a relation between words. For example, Sunita is talkative, but she is lazy. But she is lazy. It is a group of words. At the same time, here we are giving the relationship that Sunita is talkative, but she is lazy. It is a complete sentence, right? So it is a complete sentence and it has the meaning. And it has the meaning. Similarly, one more example they have given. The water is, this water is triangular. This water is triangular. This water is triangular. It does not complete the sentence. It is an incomplete sentence and it does not give the complete meaning of that particular statement. So that is the reason. Does every statement have a meaning in the sense? No. Similarly, there may exist other situations in our day-to-day life where we use statements having meaning depending upon the situation. Yes or no? Depending upon the situation, we are going to be maintaining a sentence. For a particular sentence, the combination of words is useful. Without the combination of the words, definitely the statement will not be framed. For this, I am taking the example is non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. Let us take example for this. So, non-uniform motion in the sense, in a given time interval, object will not reach the destination point. So, for example, this is my target. This is my home. Okay. నేను ఇక్కడ నుంచి స్టార్ట్అప్ చేయాలి అంటే 1 అవర్ ఆఫ్ టైం ఇంటర్వెల్ మీకు రీచ్ అవ్వడానికి, ఈ ప్లేస్కి రీచ్ అవ్వడానికి ఇచ్చిన. కానీ మీరేం చేస్తున్నారు? యు ఆర్ నాట్ రీచింగ్ ద ఎగ్జాక్ట్ టైం ఇంటర్వెల్. యు ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఈవెన్ మోర్ టైం ఇంటర్వెల్ టు రీచ్ దీస్ పాయింట్ ఫ్రమ్ పాయింట్ ఏ టు పాయింట్ బి. ఓకే, దీస్ కమ్స్ అండర్ వాట్? నాన్ యూనిఫామ్ మోషన్. ఇన్ ఎ గివెన్ టైం ఇంటర్వెల్, ఆబ్జెక్ట్ విల్ నాట్ reach the destination point. Will not reach the destination point. Is referred as non-uniform motion. Is referred as what now? Non-uniform motion. In this non-uniform motion, the graph is not linear. Okay, the graph is non-linear. The graph of non-uniform motion is non-linear. The graph is non-linear. All the points will not intersect at same time intervals. All the points will not intersect at same point. All the points will not intersect at same point. For example, like this. If you join all these lines, whether it is intersected at the same common point, whether we are getting a straight line here? No. Yes or not? It is a zigzag manner we are getting this. కర్వ్డ్ లైన్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ఓవర్ హియర్. జిగ్జాగ్ లో వస్తుంది కదా మనకి ఈ పాయింట్స్ అన్ని డ్రా చేసినప్పుడు. దిస్ ఇస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫర్ వాట్? నాన్ యూనిఫామ్ మోషన్. నాన్ యూనిఫామ్ మోషన్. లుక్ ఎట్, లెట్ అస్ అజ్యూమ్ ఎ టేబుల్ ఆర్ కాలమ్. హియర్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ఎ టేబుల్ ఆర్ కాలమ్. ఫర్ నాన్ యూనిఫామ్ మోషన్ ఆల్సో we have to take the tabular column and we must draw this tabular column. In the first column, place the distance. Distance is denoted with the symbol m, whereas in the second box we should place time. Time is denoted with the symbol t and unit of time is seconds. Here distance is denoted with the symbol S. Okay, distance is denoted with the symbol S. Unit of distance is meters. Whereas unit of time is seconds. Time is denoted with the symbol T. Okay. Near the distance, I am taking the values 40 meters. Next one is 60 meters. Next one is 80 meters, 10 meters, 30 meters. Okay. Disorder manner, I am taking the values. Highest, smallest value, highest value. Next, when we compare with the second, highest value, smallest value. Next one is highest value. Similarly, near the time also, I can take the values such as 12 seconds, next one is 8 seconds, next is 10 seconds, next is 6 seconds, next is 14 seconds. Okay, now this is the table or column. In the examination point of view, in the question paper itself, you will get this table or column. Just we have to draw the graph. Okay. So to draw this graph, we need one horizontal line, one vertical line. This is horizontal line, this is vertical line. On the surface of the horizontal line, we are taking x-axis. We are taking what? X-axis. On y-axis, this is y-axis, right? This is vertical line. On vertical line, we are taking y-axis. X-axis is also called abscissa. X-axis is also called abscissa. Y-axis is also called ordinate. Y-axis is also called what? Ordinate. Okay. On x-axis, what is the value we should mention? Here we should mention distance values, right? Distance values you have to write on x-axis. To get highest value is still 80. So starts from 0. 0, 10. Next is 20. Next is 30. Next is 40. 40. Next is 50. Next, 60. Next, 70. Next, 80. This is x-axis. Okay. Next, on y-axis, time interval is, what is the highest value here? 14 seconds. So, starts from 0. So, 2. Next, 4. Next, 6. Next, 8. Next, 12. Next, here it is 14. Okay. We have to enter in this manner. You have to observe the highest value over here. Here also you must observe the highest value. Okay. Till that value we have to enter it in a graphical representation. Now observe the point here. What is the point here? 40 meters to 12 seconds. 40 meters to 12 seconds. Here it is a 40, right? Where it is a 12? Here it is 40. From 40 to 12. Mark the point. What is the point here? 40 comma 12. 40 comma 12. Next one is 60,8. 60,8. This is 60. Here it is a 8. Here it is a 8. 60,8. Next point is 80,10. 80,10. Here it is a 80. Where is the 10? 8. After 8, we have to enter what? 10 also will be there, right? Here it is a 10. So 80,10. 80,10. 80,10. Next point is 10,6. 10,6. Here it is a 10. Where is the 6 here? Here it is a 6. 10,6. Then after 30,14. Where is the 30? Here it is a 30, right? Where is the 14? Here it is a 14. 30,14. After pointing this, now try to join all the points together. Now try to join all the points together. This is the first line. This is the second line. This is the third line representation. Next, this is the last line representation. Whether all the points are intersected at each point? No. All the points are intersected at different time intervals. So, this is the best example for what? Non-uniform motion. This is the example for what? Non-uniform motion. non-uniform motion. Is it clear? This graph is said to be what? Non-linear graph. This graph is also said to be non-linear graph. Non-linear graph. After completion of this graph, we have to write on the scale for this graph. Scale on x-axis. Scale on x-axis. So observe the difference here. Scale on x-axis. 20 minus 10. What is the difference? 10. 30 minus 20. What is the difference? 10. Similarly, 40 minus 30? 10. 50 minus 40? 10. 70 minus 60? 10. The common difference is 10. So, scale on x-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 10 units.
Sir,
1 centimeter is equals to 10 units. Similarly, write on scale on y-axis. Scale on y-axis. So, observe the difference here. 4 minus 2, 2. 6 minus 4, 2. 8 minus 6, 2. 10 minus 8, 2. 12 minus 10, 2. 14 minus 12, 2. Common difference is what? 2. Scale on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 2 units. 1 centimeter is equals to 2 units. Is it clear, Anna? Once again, I am explaining the definition of motion. A body is said to be in motion if its position is changing continuously with respect to time interval. With respect to time interval. Okay, now how we can say here? Assume it is a car. Now, it is a car. A body is said to be in motion when it has the motion. Whenever we are applying force to the object, whenever we are applying force to the object, the position of the car begins to be moved from one place to another place. Is referred as what? Motion. Depending upon the time interval, the position of the car will be differs from one place to another place. Is it clear?